Well, if you think this is how humans evolved, a new discovery may prove you are wrong and change what we know about our ancestors. Welcome back. In Eastern Europe, a discovery of an almost 2-million-year-old skull has become a bone of contention amongst scientists because it calls into question the way that we have classified our ancestors. Let me explain.
It's a discovery that's threatening to shake the leaves off our evolutionary family tree. A 1.8 million-year-old skull from one of our ancestors, Homo erectus, unearthed in recent years in Damanisi, a town in the Eastern European nation of Georgia. It was found at the same location as four incomplete skulls, all from the same time period. Up until now, a widely accepted model of the way we evolved includes several different branches of early man. Homo rudolfensis, Homo habilis, Homo erectus. Researchers looking at these new skulls say because they show such variations in appearance, they suggest that what was thought to be several species of early man are in fact just variations of one, Homo erectus. The research team says the extent of the variations between these ancient individuals is as wide as what we see in humans today. In our modern world, mankind has so many shapes, sizes, colors, and looks. This new discovery could mean that maybe our ancestors were just the same. Many unique individuals, but all the same species in the end.
Well, we've got Fred Spoor with us tonight. He's a professor of evolutionary anatomy at a University College London. He's brought his friends along with him this evening. Before we talk about what you've got here, listen, what is not in doubt is that this find is, as far as I understand, the first complete skull of an early Homo erectus. And that in itself is stunning, isn't it?
It is absolutely. It is unprecedented.
Why?
Well, because it's so complete, and there's a cranium, the top part, there's a lower jaw, there's even bones of the limbs as well. So we know a lot about this chap, because it was most likely a man. Small brain, big mouth. So that says
familiar.
It all. Yes, absolutely.
So why is this so stunningly controversial?
Well, the authors do a good description of this new skull, but then they start to interpret it. Mm. And then they, I think, go a little bit overboard. They then claim, well, the five skulls in total that we have in our place in Georgia are so variable, and still they belong to one species only. Mm. Then they go to East Africa and look at the things that have been dug up since the 70s by the Leakey family. For instance, these all come from Kenya.
Those that we've got, walk me through.
Yeah.
What have we got here?
This is Homo erectus here, classic Homo erectus. This is Homo habilis. And this is a chap called Homo rudolfensis with a very flat face. Mm. Completely the opposite in many respects from this new skull.
Break this all down for me. I know nothing about science. So what? Why do I care?
Why do you care? Because how humans evolved, there's a major debate. Did we evolve just like any other mammal and have the patterns of evolution of any other mammal? And that means that there were constantly new species emerging. The climate changes a little bit. You know, it gets drier or it gets wetter. A new species emerges to fit in that niche there. Or are we so special as humans that we actually evolved along to the like the cartoon that everybody knows, from a little hunched chimpanzee up to a complete upright human?
And you don't buy that, do you?
I don't buy that, because what they do is the best analogy that I can give. If I give you an apple and an orange, and say to you, analyze these and say if they're different. And if you just sort of put some measurements on the outside, then you say, well, they're about this size and they are round, so they must be the same thing. But yes, if you look inside, the pips are very different, the flesh is very different. It's the same with these things. If you just very broadly analyze what they look on the outside, it all looks the same.
This has got you lot really hot under your collar, this find,
well,
isn't it?
Well, you know, we work hard to try to get this out, and it's scientific debate.
Yeah.
So, you know, the truth will, you could argue, almost never be found, but the argument goes on, and every time we come a little bit closer to the truth. Mm. So we will have undoubtedly a good old row in the coming year.
Fantastic. We love a fight. Good.
There you go.
Thank you, Fred.